Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the SKS Bluemels Bicycle Fender Mudguard Set. The Bluemels Mudguards have been a popular product since the late 1800s and feature an iconic squared profile. For 2022, SKS revamped the classic Bluemels with upgraded features and blacked out aesthetics. While the fenders are offered in a variety of sizes, in this review we're specifically going to look at two sizes, the 700x28x37 variation, in both the standard version and then the style version, which has a mud flap and matte finish. So you can see packaging is very simple. These are big box, so be prepared to get a very big box in the mail if you order these online, as they are full fender, so it's front and rear and full length as well. So it's a big package, and you can see everything's on here. Specs are printed on here, and all the hardware is included with this little nifty packaging. You can see if you go to the back too, you have multiple languages and the Bluemels logo right on here. So we'll go ahead and start taking this out of the box and go over these specs. Again, they're offered in quite a few options. So if you choose the 700x28x37, which we have, then they're either $74.99 for the standard version or $84.99 for the style version, which again has the mudguard and a matte finish. These have that classic squared profile, so they look quite distinctive versus standard fenders. All the hardware is included, but you will need the eyelets for mounting or have to use an adapter clamp to achieve the same functionality. These have a breakaway safety system with the stays, which is pretty cool. So these are designed to actually just rip off the stays if you had a stick or something stuck on there, so you don't end up falling when the wheel comes to a complete stop. So it's a nice safety feature. And then these are aluminum and a plastic construction. So it's a thin piece of aluminum coated in plastic, and that's what gives it more durability. It keeps the weight really down and light. As far as what's included, you have all the hardware. So if we pop this out, but you will need some tools for the installation. So you can see here, you have all the bracketry and bolts you'll need, as well as the little adapters to connect these from your eyelets to the actual fenders. And then these are all metal stays, and these are blacked out for a little sleeker look. So you can see all the pieces. You may need a hacksaw to cut these down during the setup if these are too long. You also have the warranty information here, and then you can see all the bolts and additional back bracketry that you'll need. Compared to SKS other fenders, the Bluemels have a distinct U profile. So you can see they're much more squared off than a traditional fender and gives it a sleeker, more retro look. They offer this in two variations, the style and then the standard. You can see the standard one on the left, which is a glossy plastic, and then the style version, which is a matte finish. With the style version, you also get these edge protectors. So these little plastic pieces at the end that protect the end piece. And you get the little plastic mudguard, the 6-inch mudguard. So you can see this attaches with a little tab, and it's also removable if you just pull it off the tab on the rear. So pretty sleek, minimal branding with the matte finish as well. So it looks great on a bike, and you have all black hardware. As far as the stays, you can see they're all black, and you can cut these down to size if needed. But with this and the black fender, it's a great looking combination. Obviously you have metal stays, what looks like nice hardware, and then some of these adapters and attachment points to connect this to your mounting eyelets. You're trying to choose between the style and standard versions. Personally, I like the style version. It's about $10 more, but it has a little sleeker look. And if you want a matte finish, that's the one to go with. If we look at some of the details on here, you can see there's mounts riveted on, and this attaches to your front fork eyelet. You have little SKS tabs here just for a little design. And then again, that mudguard for the style version. They have quite a few variations of this fender as well, so you can get wider ones. The widths can do everything from more narrow road cycling tires all the way up to gravel or even touring style bikes. So you can find the one that works for you. And you can see these are full length, so it's hard to actually get on camera here on the table, but it goes all the way around. So you have full coverage and you'll protect the person behind you. They're both the same length for the style and the non one, but obviously it's just a little bit different finish. These feel like plastic, but there's actually metal on the inside. So it's quite rigid when you try to pull up or down. So once they're installed on the bike, they should be nice and rigid and not moving around. Obviously, compared to a standard bolt-on fender, this requires a bit of work to install. You're gonna have to remove your wheel and then bolt everything down. So not something you want to take on and put off for each ride, but something you want for winter or wet, rainy season and just leave it on there. Now let's go over the setup of the fenders. We're gonna install them on a Decathlon Tribin RC520, which is a really good candidate for this fender set because it has the disc brakes, enough clearance to actually fit the fenders between the seat and chainstays, and it's a good bike for all-around riding. You can see the instructions are pretty involved. SKS claims this can take up to 2 hours, which is believable, because you may actually have to cut some of these rods down to fit your application. Now, we're not going to go over every step on the setup, as you can do that with their own instruction video and the instruction pamphlet, but we'll show you the highlights. Don't worry about having extra parts as well, because there are some optional steps, so you may end up with extra washers and bolts, so I wouldn't worry about that. Here is the front fender partially assembled. You can see we have two struts. They attach to the actual fender portion with this plastic clip and this little rubber backing to prevent it from rattling. So it's a pretty stiff design. You want to make sure you orient these connectors properly. You want the bolts pointing outward so they're accessible. And then you want to make sure the top direction is correct. So you want to make sure it points toward the handlebars or toward the saddle, depending on which one you're doing. So you can see I haven't actually cut this because it fits properly. This will attach to your front fork. And then you have this top one that'll go to the top of the fork. Here is the larger rear fender. You can see it's much bigger just because it's a rear wheel. It's one piece and it doesn't have the little cutout where it would go in the chainstay region. But you can see it has a wider bolt area, so you actually have a little bit more play. You have an attachment point to the frame up here, and you can do this in different ways. For mine, it is vertical, so it works. And then again, the struts, you want to make sure you align them, then just push them in the little tabs. And this is where you can be a little time consuming. For me, these are actually too long, so if I put them on the bike, you'll see this need to be cut down a bit. As you're installing the fenders, you want to make sure you mock fit them on, so it's pretty easy to do, especially if you take off the tire and then reinstall it. And as you can see here, it's attached at 3 different points. You have the eyelets right near your dropouts, and then one bolt on the fork. So what you want to look for is a nice even gap. So here you can see it's pretty close. It's a little bit closer here and then a larger gap there. So I can adjust that with just the little 1 to 2 inch adjustment. So I can loosen that bolt, pull the strut out to get a better fit. Now, once you've done all this kind of tweaking, you're pretty much set for this bike. And if I wanted to remove this for summer, or a nice day, I just take off the 3 bolts, I'm ready to ride. So it's not as convenient as, say, a clip-on fender, which would take just a couple rubber straps. You do need to use a tool to remove it, but once it's set up, you don't really have to tweak it. So now you can see both sides are loose, so as I move this in and out, I can actually adjust the gap, and you can see it actually gets even. So I think about here, gives me a nice even gap all the way through. So definitely a nice feature, and makes it really easy to adjust without having to cut it. But this space is limited, so if you're really close or you're really far away, you will have to cut this, as you only have about a 2-inch adjustment. As you can see with the rear fender, I'm not quite as lucky. I'm definitely gonna have to cut the struts because you can see the way the chainstay flares upward. It puts these eyelets pretty high up, which means I really have to cut this down quite a bit for this to work. You can see again, there's 4 attachment points here. So you have the eyelets on each side, and this is designed to work with a variety of bikes. That's why these are so long. Then you have an attachment point up here, and this can actually be flipped horizontal or vertical. And then there's another one holding it down at this little bottom region near your bottom bracket. So that'll push it back. So you want to first adjust the struts if needed. And in my case, I'm going to have to chop off quite a bit. So almost 1 inch or something on each side, and then remeasure it, see if I can get a little bit more even. And after that, this should be able to get pulled back to give me a little bit more of a gap. One of the other tedious parts about the installation is the bottom bracket attachment. So you can see here with the style one, you don't have the cutouts like you do with the standard Bluemels. So that means you do have to kind of push this in here, and you want to make sure you have enough space. Here it looks like I do. And with a little washer here, that should place it out far enough to work. But for this part, you probably want to flip your bike over, definitely take off the wheel, and then align the bolts properly. Here you can see the fenders after the final adjustments. It's fairly even all the way across, and I had to do some major cutting on the rear struts just due to the eyelet position. But looks pretty good when you're done. And once you have the adjustment set, just torque these down to about 1 Nm, so just don't make them very tight. Just hand tight. And then those couple attachment points to the frame you want to tighten down, and then you're ready to ride. If you ever want to remove this, it's a lot easier. You don't have to do all these adjustments. Just take off the eyelets, two frame attachments, and then the fork attachment, and you can go back to a standard road bike without fenders. And one reminder before you tighten everything down, make sure you put it on the ground and just verify everything looks correct. As you can see here, I moved the front fender forward, so the bracket is in front of the fork, and now it looks a lot better instead of being so low. So you have that adjustment, both are correct, so depending on your bike, it may make more sense to have this backwards or forward, but obviously for this bike, it makes more sense to put it forward. Here you can see the fenders on our Triben bike. Overall, we were impressed with the fender performance. They have nice coverage, so the extended length protects you from any spray off the front or the rear. You do have to watch out for that front fender. You can see it extends quite a bit further down, so there's a little bit toe overlap on sharp corners. So you do have to prepare for that. Otherwise, great coverage. Riders behind you get a little bit of spray, but it is partially covered as the rear fender extends fairly far downward. We really like the style variation as well because it has a matte finish. And you can see the integrated strut connection, so much smoother exterior design with those mudguards. Also, we were impressed with the rigidity of the fenders. They really hold their form pretty well, so even if you're going over potholes or light gravel riding, you won't get any rub with the tires. And if you leave the gap properly set up, debris and dirt can get through it. So overall, really nice set of fenders. So if you want something that looks a little bit classic, it gives you good protection, then the Bluemel, updated Bluemels are a great option. Now let's go over the pros and cons for the Bluemel fenders. What we like about them is that they have an iconic fender shape. It's a classic yet modern design with a squared off profile. And the fenders are also lightweight yet rigid with the aluminum and plastic construction. We also like the fact that they are highly adjustable, so they should work on most bike geometries and you can get the gap right at all the locations. Some of the cons for these fenders is the fact that it is time consuming for the initial setup as you may need to cut down the struts and there are multiple contact points so you'll need some tools. Also, with the style version of the fenders, they don't have a cutout near the bottom bracket, so you do need to make sure you have enough space there to accommodate the fenders. Taking everything into account would give the Bluemel fenders an 8.7 out of 10. They're iconic yet modern fenders that look great on a road bike or urban bike. Thanks for watching this review, and don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclist. This is The Sweet Cyclist reminding you to enjoy the ride.